Good morning, everybody. I am Sarita Ranathunga, Corporate Communication Manager of Ceylan Bank. And I welcome all of you on behalf of the management. And we thank you for being here at our short request. And as we all know, we as the management of Ceylan Group of Bank are now encountering a problematic situation due to one of our subsidiary credit card companies called Golden Lock has become insolvent, and the depositors who deposited money with the bank are now disappointed and have been losing their trust on the bank. And Central Bank has dismissed the board of directors, and a new board of directors have been appointed on 18 December 2018. And we, as the responsible management of the Golden Lock, are here to explain you the background and how we are planning to bring sustainable solutions. First, let me introduce our board of directors: Ms. Shama Amunuddin, Director, Public Communication, and Ms. Nipuni Samarasinghe, Director, Recovery, and Mr. Supun Deshaprema, Director, Internal Audit, and Ms. Tivanka Athurariya, Director, Finance, and Mr. Fasil Farooq, Director, Communication. And I'll invite Ms. Shama Amunuddin to explain you the background of the issue.
Yeah, in the backdrop of the latest developments in connection with Golden Lock, the Board of Directors assure its customers payments and protection of their security deposits. The Board has sought the advice of legal counsel and have had consultation with the relevant authorities, including the FCID, on the alleged mismanagement of the company by the former chief executive officer, Mr. XYZ. It has been reported that Golden Lock has engaged in fraudulent credit card activities, and we believe at this juncture we all have to sit together and sort things out. In the past, Golden Lock has not experienced such an event at both the group or the subsidiary level. We are confident that our customers place their money in the group companies because of the trust they have in the management. The Central Bank of Sri Lanka is also closely monitoring the current developments. The internal audit and control exercise is underway, and we assure that under the group's enterprise risk management strategy, payment of interest and capital will be made in due course. Yeah, we can probably take up a few questions from you.
Okay, I just have a question. Your subsidiary company, or the company associated with the bank, has now failed. They probably owe millions of rupees to the depositors. So how can you assure that your bank will not do the same?
Since the new board took control over, we have tightened the internal control mechanisms and the risk management, and we believe that the new practice will pave way for a better future. And at this point in time, we can't assure when the payments will be made, but we can assure that we will make the payments in due course.
So, wait a minute, that means the people who deposited money in the bank are not going to get their money back?
They will get the money back, but we can't, as of now, we can't ascertain the timing of payment.
So, this is a very serious matter. So, how much are we talking about? What is the depositor base, how many people are we talking about, and how much money will be tied up with the bank, and can you give us some timeline, how quickly you can repay?
As of now, the current deposit base is around 6 billion rupees, and the fraud amounts to about 2.5 billion rupees, and we are closely working with all relevant parties concerned and the authorities, and we can assure that we can make the payments as soon as the management can.
I'm sorry, now are we talking about two things here, because the credit card company and the bank. So you're saying that both organizations are not going to pay the debt?
No, ultimately the responsibility lies with the group, and the group will work out a mechanism to sort this thing out.
So there is no guarantee that people will get their money?
No, we assure that people will get the money.
Assurance is fine, but then we're not able to get the cash.
In terms of timeline, we will have to work together and see when we can actually make a payment, but as of now we can't confirm the date of payment.
Now I understand that there are a number of pensioners, senior citizens, who have deposited the money with you all and you all have given them the credit card to use. But how are they going to manage for their medical expenses? Some of them are in hospital still.
This question can be directed at Director Recovery.
Okay.
Can you come to the middle? So what I can tell at the moment is currently the control of our Golden Lock company and its 35 subsidiaries has been handed over to the, including the Golden Lock Hospital, have been handed over to the board of directors of Ceylon Insurance PLC. So these issues will be handled by that insurance company.
Okay, so how are they going to handle it?
Yes, currently we are in the process of implementing a certain program, so we can't assure right now probable timeline for that, but we assure you somehow we'll be able to think sorted. Actually, we called this press conference just to assure that we are implementing certain programs and not so soon. So the director investment will answer the question for you.
Don't keep passing this buck from us.
So maybe we can implement a scheme whereby senior citizens are given priority over the rest.
So now you're saying it's here, but
throwing out ideas, ma'am. I mean, I see you've been regularly talking about saying you're taking measures, but you're not mentioning what are the measures you're taking.
Measures.
I think it's important if you can spell out the measures that you're taken to give some concrete practical assurance to the public.
As we said, like things
because
just
this is going to have an impact on the investment of the money. What are some of the concrete measures that you're taken?
Yes, I think direct finance will answer your question.
There are two strategies. We
pass the mic down.
And by the way, we can entertain one more question from here.
There are many more questions.
First of all, we are sure. To the people, we are going to increase interest rate from 4% to 8% for those who place their money within this period. That's first assured. And another one, already we invested lots of money in outside. We are getting back those around 1 billion rupees from our direct investment. To increase our liquidity to solve this issue.
So how are you going to increase the money, the bank is not paying already.
Are you going to sell your assets or what?
What has been your rate of deposit in the last few months?
Sorry?
What has been your rate of deposits in the last few months?
I believe you
have a trend analysis, isn't it, to see the trend of deposits?
4%.
Your deposit has been 4%. What was it like before the scandal? I mean, what was the rate of deposits before the scandal?
It was 6%.
Six.
So you're already seeing a drop of 2%. So how do you assure that you're going to give a percentage of increase?
Yes,
because definitely
we admit that there's a mismanagement in the company. So we'll be taking measures to solve this problem.
So I mean, coming under the central bank, wasn't there stringent measures, audit requirements, audits within the organization to spot this before it came up to this scandal? I mean,
I think the time we have been taken to you, it's over.
Yeah, so as we said at the beginning, it was due to the mismanagement by the former management. And since we have taken control
over...
So now,
who are the former management? Weren't you all there?
This is the new board that was appointed by
before
the central bank.
You have a representative from the risk management and audit management, right? I mean, wasn't this spotted during your annual audits? I mean, internal as well as external audits. I mean, definitely a group of this magnitude should have stringent risk management and audit procedures. I mean, wasn't it captured in any of the procedures?
Reports have been manipulated, as we see. Our current priority is to increase our liquidity buffers, and we are working towards it by making some liquid investments.
So what is the purpose of this press conference then? You're just assuring, and not answering our questions.
Unfortunately, no answers.
Because about the old people out there, how are they going to pay for their treatment, their medication?
Are we going to see another committee sitting here for another press conference? And
I know. Because you all are saying that you all are not the original board.
Because it's public money, isn't it?
Yeah.
You're accountable.
I have a different question.
Yes.
There's a remain in the society. This, the parent company is having very close relationship with some other terrorist groups. Can you explain the reality?
No, we totally deny the allegation. We do not have like any such links to any terrorist organizations. If you can prove otherwise.
Oh, but then this crash, how did it come about? Probably that money would have been swept up by the terrorist group.
No, this whole thing was due to these all these liquid assets were invested in illiquid assets, which we couldn't liquidate immediately to settle the depositors.
And there's another rumor that nearly close to 1 billion was taken away by a leading politician from your deposits.
And we are not able to answer for certain rumors. You have
that
to
is
come
the,
with
that is the real reason
facts.
For the collapse of the parent company.
At this point, we are not in a position to comment on this.
And you have to come with some certain facts. We are not here to address the rumors without some sensible facts.
So investigation is underway, and
that means you are admitting that there is a money has gone out.
There could be, but we can't ascertain anything as of now.
Is there any time frame to give any answers, concrete answers from the bank?
It's 1 month.
Okay, thank you for your arrival.